Hi guys, this is Asmia. Welcome to my channel. I hope you all are doing fine. Today I'll be sharing with you on how I styled the netted sari in an Indo-Western style. Also, I made a belt using basic supplies at home. I'll also be explaining on how I did that. So, if you like the video, please do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Let's start! So the first step is to wear a matching colored petticoat and a blouse that complements the sari. And also, before draping the sari, don't forget to wear your heels. Now this is the netted sari that I will be using. It is from my mom's cupboard, obviously. Going to the non-pallu end of the sari, tie a knot at the topmost corner and tuck it in on the waist. Wrap the sari around once. Once it's completely wrapped around and tucked in all around the waist, go to the pallu end, wrap the sari again and place it on the shoulder. On the left side of the shoulder ideally. Here I'm placing on the right side of the shoulder so that it's easier for me to make the pleats on the waist. Identify the length of the pallu required and then bring the sari from the shoulder to the waist back again. To give the sari a proper fitted look on the body, bring the sari to the waist and secure it with a safety pin by pulling it tight so that it fits perfectly on the body. The rest of the fabric that is hanging on the waist will be made into pleats. Then the pleats are arranged such that they are 1 mm apart from each other. Secure it with a safety pin and tucking it into the waist so that it stays intact. The next step is the crucial one and it gives a unique styling to the sari. So here it's how I styled the pleats. First, fold the pallu in half and from the folded edge, make pleats until we come towards the embroidery section of the end of the border. Now secure only the pleats section with a safety pin by leaving the two borders of the two ends open so that the two borders are visible and the pleats are behind. Do the same thing on the various section of the pallu, then place it on the left side of the shoulder. Bring the pallu from the shoulder to the side seam and secure it with a safety pin or we could even tuck it. Arrange the pallu on the shoulder so that only the two borders are visible and secure it to the blouse with a safety pin. The next step is to wear a belt. Now to tell you it is difficult or actually rather expensive to find a designer belt. So here's my jugaad. I made a belt using two different types of lace. Though here I was in a hurry, and that is the reason I am securing it with a safety pin. But I will be showing you on how to make the belt with hooks so that they can be used for future purpose as well. To make the belt, I used two different types of lace that measured of my waist size and I hand stitched them together using backstitch. To make the belt sturdy, I attached a piece of fabric that is twice the width of the belt and of the same length. Then attached hooks at the end of the belt. So here the belt is ready. It took me like 15 minutes to make it. So the sari drape is ready. Now for the hair. Firstly, I comb the hair throughout so that there are no knots, and then took sections of hair on two sides and slightly back combed so that it gives an illusion that my hair has a lot of volume. Taking the section of hair from the two sides where I did the back combing, I will be slightly brushing it on top so that the back combing doesn't go away, but the hair looks neatly finished, and then securing the section with a bobby pin. So the next thing I plan to do is curl the ends of the hair, for which I will be using the Philips hair straightener. Firstly, I will be using the L'Oreal serum for minimum heat damage. After using the hair serum, I left my hair for about 5 minutes so that it takes in all the goodness of the serum, and then I started to curl my hair with the hair straightener which I have. So here I will be taking sections of hair. Firstly, I have taken a small section of hair, placed the flat iron on the top, and twisting the iron towards the head, I will be pulling the straightener till the end. So you see the hair curls. Hold the section of hair to form a coil until they are cooled down so that the curls remain intact. Taking small section of hair each time, do the same thing, that is placing the section of hair in between the flat iron, flipping it towards the head, and then pulling it down very gently to form curls, and then holding the curls into a coil until they cool down so that the curls remain intact. Now, once I have completed curling throughout the volume of my hair, the curls do not last long, for more than like 20 minutes if I do not do anything on them. So to give them a strong hold, here I will be using the L'Oreal Elnett Satin Hairspray. This gives a stronger hold and also it gives a shine to the hair, which I really love. Of course, I don't use this on all occasions. It's only when I curl my hair and when I style them in a different way. Otherwise, I do not recommend, or I do not personally use a lot of products on my hair. So this is how the curls look like. And do let me know by commenting down below how you found it. I accessorized the sari with lots of silver bangles in one hand and American diamond drop earrings along with heels. I really liked how the look turned out. If you did too, don't forget to like the video, share it among your friends, and please do subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you in my next video. Until then, take care. Bye.